Hi, I'm Eric Kraft, co-chairman of Enterprise Connect and editor of NoJitter.com. I'm here on the Enterprise Connect show floor. I'm speaking with Roberto Ricosa from Avaya. Welcome, Roberto.
Excellent, Eric. How are you?
Very well, thanks. I'm delighted to be here with you, and we're delighted to have Avaya here.
Likewise.
At the recent keynote that Kevin Kennedy gave this week, he spent a lot of time describing the network that Avaya built for the recent Sochi Winter Olympics and what that has to do with enabling communications to work better. Explain a little bit about what he was talking about.
Right. So basically, first of all, I'd like to clarify one thing that people have probably a misconception, which is that Avaya was a sponsor of the Olympics. And that is definitely not the case. Avaya was the official supplier of the entire network infrastructure for the Sochi Olympics. So basically what happened was we were selected as a very rigorous RFP process several years ago, and based on the technology and based on the experience that we have, because we've done this kind of Olympics before, we got selected to provide the entire network infrastructure for the Sochi Olympics. So again, it's a great thing that we're able to demonstrate what kind of technology we have. And if you think about it, the Olympics were just a proof point of what kind of the technology that is needed to drive everything that is all the way from communication for voice, video, and one of the most important things is that this Olympics were probably one of the most different things that everybody has seen, is the fact that this Olympics were the first social media Olympics. Basically what happened was, at the minute that the Olympics started, basically 120,000 devices got connected through Wi-Fi connectivity, and everybody started tweeting, loading up pictures, sending out videos, and that, as you can imagine, had a tremendous amount of bandwidth requirements, and of course a lot of resiliency that was able to be provided by Avaya Solutions.
Well, it's interesting because being the Olympics happening every 4 years, you have the opportunity to sort of benchmark or compare one to the next. And Kevin presented some statistics there about, you mentioned sort of the usage of the network, and we can think about how that compares to 4 years ago. Right. Kevin also mentioned the sort of the infrastructure of the network from the 2010 games that you did in Vancouver and the 2014 games, how much more capital expense was involved in the 2010 network, and just, you know, it was a really good benchmark for how far the technology's advanced.
Absolutely, and also not only the kind of course the benefits of the cost itself, but also how the difference between the Olympics in Vancouver versus the Olympics in Sochi, around the fact that the traffic was completely reverted between wireless and wired connectivity. So about 80% of the traffic in Sochi was through wireless connectivity, and that again just brings a tremendous amount of a risk and a complexity to the network. But again, it's really, really proud that the results that we're able to see, it's by far the best Olympics ever.
So Avaya has always been one of the mainstays of this industry, and you're still the installed base leader after so many years in communications. But so much has changed in the industry, and Avaya's made a lot of changes with it. What, as you look at the industry now and the changes that we're seeing, what's particularly interesting and what's compelling to Avaya, and what can we expect from Avaya in the next 12 months?
So making a connection to the Olympics, one of the biggest differences that we were able to implement was Fabric Connect, which is the technology that has allowed basically the entire set of communications for Sochi to be able to deliver the kind of power that it was required. So that is something that we see coming down the line, is all the different vehicles of communications and the reality of bring your own device turning into something that is here and here to stay, with a combination of social media, not only for the individuals but also into the companies. Those are the different things that are going to start putting a lot of pressure into the networks. And again, Avaya has demonstrated that we can do that once and over again. And we show that very interestingly, not only in the Sochi games, but also we also highlighted that the fact that if we're able to do this for a 50,000 Ethernet connection points, as well as all the different devices we connected, just imagine what we can do to a smaller size companies. And we also demonstrated that by showcasing the Cake Boss, which is another very interesting case of a company that is a mid-size who started from a very small company and has actually grown to more than 300 employees with millions of dollars of revenue, and has plans to grow to more than 1,000 employees in the next year. So again, this is just a proof point of the fact that our technology expands not only from the super large companies, but also to the smaller size companies. In terms of technology, I would definitely see a lot around mobility, a lot around video, and a lot around the different kinds of solutions that are needed for the social networking as well as the contact center space. So all these things are really exactly where Avaya is at the cornerstone of all these technologies.
Well, that was the interesting thing in the Cake Boss video that you guys showed, that he's there running his business, baking his cakes, and he's working on his iPhone and his iPad,
right.
and he's talking about Avaya, but you're not seeing an Avaya phone or an Avaya switch even. It's all about
right.
what somebody's doing with their endpoint.
Exactly.
Is that for a company that's been putting your logo on phones for generations, different logos over time,
right.
is that comfortable to be on a device that's not an Avaya device but software running
well, but
on it?
I mean, and that's exactly what we're trying to do is to maximize the BYOD trend by enabling any kind of device that the consumers might have or the customers might have. And ultimately, the logo of Avaya is still going to be there on the application itself. So you're going to have to double click to open that application. And the application itself is also Avaya. And of course, our footprint for Avaya phones throughout the world continues to be out there. So our Avaya brand is extremely powerful.
Terrific. Well, Roberto Roccosa, thank you very much for joining us here. And appreciate you being an Enterprise Connect.
Excellent. Thank you very much. And thank you, everyone.